குட் ஈவினிங் ஆல். நாசா சார், நம்ம ஆரம்பிச்சிடலாமா? நமக்கு எக்ஸாக்டாக 3:30க்கு முடிச்சிடற மாதிரி பண்ணிடலாம். ஏன்னா கெஸ்ட்லாம் வந்துட்டாங்க. எப்படி, நம்ம வேணால் ஒரு 2-3 மினிட்ஸ் வெயிட் பண்ணலாம்.
Yeah, let's start at 2:05. Okay, I think it's time. Mr. Rajaraman and his team is here. Yeah, I believe this is today's session is an important one because they are going to detail us how some other universities and colleges are doing, and especially how they are utilizing the Wikimedia in their institutions with these few words. I'm handing over this platform to Mr. Raja Rams and his team.
Okay.
Thank you, Mr. Yep.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. So far in past 2 days, we have seen about what is Wikipedia as well as other sister projects in Wikimedia. So I hope you have some idea about how it is working and how the volunteers are involving and how they are contributing. And also, I have one more request. Once you create your username, please sign in our meta page. Meta page is nothing but the event page. I also share that link in our chat box. Okay, just go to the participant and then put your signature. That is for just for record that you have attended this session, so that in future you can realize this event and you can remember it. Just even for our purpose, we can consider your participation in this event. Okay, Now, in this today's session, we have a special four guests from various community. We have Jayanta and Subodh Kulkarni from CIS A2K. I have already mentioned about CIS A2K. It's an affiliated partner of Wikimedia Foundation of Indian region. And we have Aswin and Gaurav from English Wikipedia as well as Punjabi Wikipedia. They are going to share their experience in community collaboration with Wikipedia as well as other education institution. I hope the session will be more useful as well as more interesting. You can also raise your question. And also we have one more constraint is time. We are trying to complete before 3:30, but maybe based on that discussion, it may go more or less around 10 to 15 minutes around 3:30. We will hand over the session to Subodh Kulkarni. He's from CIS A2K, a program officer. Subodh, can you take the floor?
Yes, sure.
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome all, and thanks for the invitation extended by Nitin Karan and the JK and institutions. I was just going through the website of the your institution. So it's a pretty old institution, 50 plus year old trust, and the work is fabulous in various sectors. You are doing very well in various sectors, educational sectors, as well as the developmental sectors. I am going to share some of my experience regarding the institutional partnerships we have in the last 3 to 4 years in the Wikimedia movement. So I will go through shortly through the various pages because there is very less time. 10 minutes are there, and I will go through all the pages. Afterwards, I will share all the links with you. Details can be seen on all those links, and you can get back to me for any clarification or any support in the future. We all know that the Wikimedia movement has been there in India for the last 10 plus years, thriving to create free knowledge in every language in all the Indian states. But we all know that the society is into knowledge creation, into knowledge dissemination for centuries. So there are different institutions, different voluntary organizations, different trusts, different charitable trusts, different research organizations, which are creating knowledge and disseminating knowledge to the society for centuries, we can say. We cannot develop in isolation in the society. So we are like gatherers of knowledge, we are compilers of knowledge. So in Wikimedia movement, we say that sum of all knowledge we are going to create. So if we visualize a beehive where honeybees are collecting nectar from every flower in the area. So if we visualize that Wikimedia movement and projects are a beehive, and we are going to different knowledge gardens and collecting droplets of honey, droplets of knowledge, and collecting that into our various projects. So there are different such knowledge gardens around in our society, we all know. But when we thought of knowledge creation with them, there are different experiences with them. So I will share my screen, and I will go through one by one. So hope you can see my screen now. So this is a page. This is on Meta Wikimedia, CIS A2K Institutional Partners. So here I have compiled all the links with whom we are working in the last 3-4 years. So I will click one by one, and I will show you briefly. I will share the experiences with them. There were many events which we conducted with the libraries. So libraries, we all know that they are repositories of knowledge. So we conducted, you can see various events with them from 2017. So we introduced them to the digitization process. Then Wikisource project, because the Wikisource is a thriving, developing free online library, and all the libraries are experiencing limitations in getting readers, getting the subscriptions, etc. So they know that the world is changing, and they have to shift to the online forum very well. So we introduced them to the digitization and Wikisource workshops, and then with the libraries, you can see how the partnerships have developed. There were different research organizations also with whom we collaborated. And then we are now starting the digitization projects with the 150-year-old libraries. So there are many 100-plus-year-old libraries in Maharashtra. So we have made a list of them, and we are listing the rare and old books with them, and we are digitizing these books. So first project was with Rajgurunagar Library, which is a 125-plus-year-old library. From them, we are digitizing all the books before 1900. So as of now, we have digitized nearly 25-plus books before 1900, and we have uploaded them into Commons, and they have been OCR'd and converted into Unicode also in the Wikisource. So these are the different libraries with whom we are working. There is a very old library plus research institution called Bhandarkar Oriental Research Institute, with whom also we are collaborating. Then we, after collaborating with all them, so we thought of mapping all these institutions in Maharashtra. So last year we started mapping these institutions. GLAM institutions. GLAM is galleries, libraries, archives, and museums. So we are mapping these institutions, and you can see we are visiting these institutions with the help of Wikimedians, active Wikimedians, and we are exploring the potential of digitizing their resources. Like there are various paintings, where are manuscripts, then old books are there. So a whole lot of knowledge is there in all these museums as well as the libraries. So we have started mapping them and sharing the Wikimedia projects, principles, and the processes of digitization with them. And then these were the observations. You can go through all of them. There are some technical challenges are there, some administrative challenges are there, but there is a vast scope for bringing all these GLAMs, like galleries, libraries, into Wikimedia projects. So in the vicinity, you can also take up this GLAM mapping project with the help of students, and you can alert them some blocks or some wards, and you can map the institutions. So this GLAM mapping project is worth taking in your institutions. Then there are many organizations which are working thematic issues. So there is one organization, Lake Ladki Abhiyan, which is working for the last 30 plus years around the women's issues. So they have large repositories of knowledge regarding the women's laws, women's health, women's social issues, and other things. So we started collaborating with them from 2017. There was a small workshop to introduce Wikimedia projects. Then every year on the Women's Day, we are collaborating with them. And now it has happened that in the last 2 years, they are taking the initiative, and we are just facilitating them. So they are coming up with different ideas how to celebrate the Women History Month. This year they came up with very innovative idea because it was all Corona everywhere, pandemic was there, and they thought of documenting the women at work theme. So they documented the women at work in various sectors. So there are various enterprises which are male dominated. So if you think of construction industry, it is majorly the male dominated industry or the transport sector. But there are women which are working in this sector for the last 20 plus years. So they documented all these stories of women at work. So this was a different initiative taken up by them. You can also replicate this idea at your. So if you can see, they made a small videos of. So they made small videos of women working in different sectors. The videos, I think the internet issue is there, so they will not play very fast. So this year they documented the women at work. Last year they released their books. Released their content donation sessions were held by them, and the knowledge about women and the knowledge created by women was released into free license. So with Lake Ladaki Abhiyan, we are working for the last 4 years. Then there are different institutions. We are working with state governments, Marathi departments also for the last 4 years. So we introduced every year the language day is there on 27 February in Maharashtra. So there used to be events like some lecture. They used to conduct some lecture. They used to conduct some rally around the Marathi language, etc. But we introduced the idea of knowledge creation on the Marathi language day, and the Wikipedia workshops were arranged by us in the first year. But in the very next year, they taken up that idea, and you can see in year 2017, the first series of workshops were there. Only three workshops we conducted on behalf of them in various colleges. And the second series in 2018, 17 workshops were conducted across the state. So the first series was there in 2 to 3 districts. But in the next year, we reached up to 17 districts in the state. And 2019, there were again many more districts and many more workshops were there. So in the last 4 years, we have conducted many workshops, and the education institutes were introduced to Wikimedia projects. They have integrated some of their academic assignments with the Wikimedia projects. Mass communication and journalism student has to publish one article directly on Wikimedia with proper references, proper photographs, etc. So that is the assignment. So they are not like printing the pages anymore. They are just creating the article, well referenced article on Wikipedia, and they are giving the link in the submission. So this kind of activities were taken up gradually in the last 4 years. So this is how the program was evolved in various institutions. So now there is a great response every year. Like we don't get enough resource persons to attend train various colleges. So there is a great demand for this workshop. Students are also, the computer labs were being utilized for the first time. All the computer labs you can see were involved, were engaged in the Wikimedia content generation production. So previously the computer labs were not much utilized, but due to this activity, the labs were also rejuvenated, and the computers were repaired. Everything was there in place. So due to this consistent partnership, then the important partnership with Vigyan Ashram. So Vigyan Ashram is a educational center in rural area of Maharashtra. So there they train the rural youth in entrepreneurship development and the skills development. So we have collaboration with them. We started the digitization project with them in the last 3 years, and we have nearly digitized 50,000 plus pages there. We have created one documentary also on this. Savitri cha online leki, Savitri by Phule, you know, she was a pioneer in the women's education. So Savitri's Online Daughters is a documentary made on the Vigyan Ashram's work. So there were different projects with the Vigyan Ashram. We have developed an MOU also with Vigyan Ashram, in which the various responsibilities, what are the objectives, etc., what A2K will do, what Vigyan Ashram will do. So such kind of small MOUs you can develop with various institutions according to the scope of the project. So this is the partnership with Vigyan Ashram. Then we have partnered with various authors, publishing houses for the relicensing of the content. So you all know that many books are not being printed for the last 20 plus years. The books printed in before 2020 are not being printed now. So there are a lot of books which can we can relicense and bring the, all that valuable reference material into Wikimedia Commons. So in the last 4 years, I will show you the progress of this relicensing. We started appealing various authors and publishers and copyright holders to release their books into free license. So in 2017-18, we started the notable scientist and author Jayant Nadkarni, Mangala Nadkarni, and Iravati Kerve. These were the very notable authors who released their material. And then we took up that idea across the state. And 2018-19, we got 36 books. In 1920, 102 books. And you can see the gradually the number is increasing. In 2021, we the released nearly 136 books. So we are just facilitating this process now. People are coming forward. The mouth-to-mouth publicity is there. We are conducting some promotional sessions also on the occasion of Language Day and other notable days, Library Day and other days. So the relicensing also you can take up in which organizations are also involved. So this is the story of relicensing on Meta. You can also see this story of relicensing where now the thematic organizations are also coming forward to release their works. So we collaborated with Shetkari Sanghatna Trust to release all their agriculture and other issues related material. So you can see. Then we collaborated with one organization here who donated their very recent encyclopedias, which are still being sold at higher prices in the market. So we can convince the various organizations for relicensing. Here we can see some of the links like. So you can see the encyclopedias. These are Shilpakar Charitra Kosh. The volumes are Shilpakar Charitra Kosh. The people who shaped the various sectors in Maharashtra. So the thematic encyclopedias are there regarding the administration, then history, literature, science and technology, animal husbandry, then arts and culture, etc. So this kind of relicensing has been there. Then I will end with one more the thematic partnership which is being developed. We are developing Project Jalabodh, that is all the knowledge around water is being accumulated at one place. So we started with some organizations working on water related issues in 2017, and gradually the organizations are joining. We had one dialogue on urban rivers also in Maharashtra. So there are different workshops with all the river activists. And then the Tarun Bharat Sangh, you all know Rajendra Singh, Waterman of India. He is leading all the river related movements in India. So we had one national level workshop. And after that, the knowledge in different languages is being accumulated under the project of Jalabodh. So here you can see national level organizations are volunteers are involved in collecting the knowledge around the water. So after this, we felt that there is a dearth of very less reference material regarding the rivers on in internet. So we requested Tarun Bharat Sangh to release their works also. Relicensing was done by Tarun Bharat Sangh. So you can see the gradual development of the project from 2017 to 20. Now they are leading the knowledge generation, and we are just facilitating. We are giving the digitization support, and we are giving some other financial support for holding the events. But now they are organizing the events. So you can see the relicensing was done by Tarun Bharat Sangh. First they released some few books, but then they felt that many more books can be released. So you can see now this is the biggest relicensing in India, we can say. So these are the Hindi books. So yeah, there are nearly 75 books on different rivers of India. This is very valuable reference material, you can see. The related river related laws and other various reports, very important reports are there in this. So they release Hindi books as well as the English books. So total nearly 90 books have been released by the Tarun Bharat Sangh on river related and water related issues. So this is a great repository now on water. So gradually people are following these examples and they are releasing their own works. Some people have released their works in the health sector, then agricultural sector. So different sectors, yeah, Vigyan Ashram has released their works in the science and technology sector. So gradually these partnerships are growing and more people are joining in this moment. So that's all for now, because I have, I think, taken 5 minutes more. So I will stop here, and if there are any questions, I will answer them, or the facilitators can decide. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Subodh Kulkarni. Staff, so do you have any questions regarding this? I would like to summary in Tamil. இவங்க குறிப்பா என்ன சொன்னாங்கன்னா, இப்ப நிறைய அமைப்புகளோட சேர்ந்து ஆவணம் படுத்திருக்காங்க, டாக்குமெண்டேஷன் கூட பண்ணியிருக்காங்க. அதே மாதிரி புத்தகங்கள் கூட நன்கொடை வாங்கியிருக்காங்க, புக் டொனேஷன் இந்த மாதிரி லைப்ரரிகள் மூலமாக பண்ணியிருக்காங்க. குறிப்பா கல்வி நிலையங்களில் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, ஜேர்னலிசம் குறிப்பா அந்த துறையில இருக்கக்கூடியவங்களுக்கு வந்து அசைன்மெண்ட்டாகவே கொடுத்துருக்காங்க. அவங்களுடைய பாடத்திட்டங்களை ஒரு அசைன்மெண்ட்டாகவே வந்து விக்கிபீடியால ஒரு கட்டுரை எழுதணும், பிளஸ் அந்த ரெஃபரன்ஸோட எழுதுறப்ப வந்து அது ஒரு அசைன்மெண்ட்டாக கொடுத்துருக்காங்க. சார் சொல்ல விட்ட இன்னொரு ஒரு கல்லூரி பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, கிறிஸ்டி யூனிவர்சிட்டி இருக்கு, மேபி டைம் கன்ஸ்டன்டாக விட்டுருக்கலாம். அவங்கெல்லாம் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா அவங்க சிலபஸ்லேயே வச்சிருக்காங்க அந்த பாடத்திட்டங்களை. அவங்களுடைய பிஜி மேத்தமெட்டிக்ஸ் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ்க்கு வந்து விக்கிபீடியாவுடைய எடிட்டிங் அதே மாதிரி அதில் கூடிய கான்ட்ரிபியூஷன் வந்து சிலபஸில் ஒரு பேப்பராகவே வச்சிருக்காங்க. நான் அதை பற்றி லிங்க் கூட இங்கே போடுறேன். இதில் டவுட்ஸ் இல்லாட்டி நம்ம நெக்ஸ்ட் செஷனுக்கு வி வில் இன்வைட் ஜெயந்தா. எனி அதர் குவஸ்டின்ஸ்? Okay, if there is no other questions, then we will invite Jayanta.
So, questions, let's have at the end of the session.
Okay, okay, then good. Okay, good. Yeah. Jayanta, can you take the session? Jayanta Nath, are you the...
So the questions, because
Hello.
we are leaving now in few minutes. So yes. That's why if there is any important question, you can... go ahead, because Jayant and myself have an important meeting at 3 p.m. So we are leaving
okay.
At 2:45. Okay.
Okay, Nishil. Am I audible?
Yes, yes, Jayanta.
Yes. So thank you, Nishil and Chakran, and thank you invite for me for during this session. And I am sharing with the which we have done from West Bengal. With the collaboration with the National Digital Library. And all you know that the National Digital Library is a project under Ministry of Education, Government of India. The objects of this is to collect metadata to provide the full text index and the several national and international digital library, as well as other relevant sources. It is a digital repository containing textbooks, articles, videos, audio books, lectures, stimulations, fixants, and all other kind of learning mode. And the NDLI is National Digital Library, is not is a digital library of India, which was previously previous website. They are actually shut down due to some copyright reasons. But as of now, National Digital Library has a major partners of the Ministry of Education in Government of India. And actually, I am sharing my screen to show how we actually collaboration with them. And we have several of meeting last 2 years with the IIT Kharagpur. And their professor Parthapratim Das is the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at IIT Kharagpur, and he's a joint investigator, principal investigator of NDLI. Professor Pavit Pavan Bhomik is the assistant professor, and he is a main technical persons of this NDLI team. And we have several meetings with them, with the, our Wikisource team. As of now, I am a Wikisource program officer. So I and our friend or colleague Bodhisattva has joined me, and we did several talks with them, several meetings with them. Finally, a final meeting was held in Delhi, and with our foundation team, with CIS team, and NDLI team, and we sign up a MOU. After the sign of the memorandum of understanding, we have lots of work with them and lots of technicals meeting with them. After that, they have published their our Wikisource books to their website. I'm just sharing with a few things to share what where they are published. One second.
So Jayantanath is specialized in Wikisource. He's a program advisor for Wikisource in Indian region. So he's basically belong to Bengali community. அவர் அனிமா திருப்பி ஷேர் பண்ண வர நினைக்கிறேன். ஒருவேளை இன்டர்நெட் இஷ்யூவாக இருக்கலாம். இவங்க ஆக்சுவலாக வந்து உங்கள் ஃபஸ்ட்டு பேசின ரெண்டு பேரும் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா சிஏஎஸ் ஏடிக்கோயுடைய ஆக்சுவல் எம்ப்ளாயீஸ். ஸோ மேபி அவங்களுக்கு 3 o'clock வேறு ஒரு மீட்டிங் இருக்கனால வந்து இந்த ஃபஸ்ட்டு பார்ட் அவங்களுக்கு கொடுத்துருக்கோம். ஸோ ஏதாவது கொஸ்டின்ஸ் இருந்தால் கூட இவர் செஷன் எண்டில் கூட நம்ம கேட்கலாம். ஸோ சிஏஎஸ் வந்து என்ன மாதிரியான கான்ட்ரிபியூஷன் அவங்க நமக்கு சப்போர்ட் பண்ணுவாங்க அப்படிங்கிற ஒருவேளை உங்களுக்கு தேவைப்படுச்சா கேட்கலாம். ப்ளஸ் இந்த டாக்குமெண்டேஷனுக்கெலாம் வந்து அவங்களுடைய ஸ்பான்சரில் நம்ம பண்ண முடியும். ஸோ இன்கேஸ் அந்த மாதிரி ஐடியா இருந்துச்சுன்னா கூட நீங்கள் அவங்கள கூட கான்டாக்ட் பண்ணலாம்.
ஓகே சாரி, ஐ ஹவ் டிஸ்கனெக்டட், சாரி ஃபார் திஸ். ஹலோ.
Yes, continue.
And this is a National Digital Library website, and you can see there's you can see that lots of subjects and lots of you can explore these, and it is searchable with the three languages, and day by day they are searching languages also, and interface language it is a you can see that the most of the languages here, including all four South Indian language also. And if you can browse with the subject tab and source, and you can, if you go with the source tab, and there is a lots of source, different kind of source available. If you go with a Wikisource, Wikisource, then you can see there is a all. They have already uploaded few books, not a whole books in English or other language. They have only uploaded, if you go with the language specific, you can see this is a language of book, different kind of language they have already uploaded. And you can see that Bengali, most of the books is uploaded in 152 and English 970 books. And this is the most of the Wikisource language, which is a green or 100% validated books, is me to say that. They are trying to add the 100% validated books, and day by day, they will add the others language also. As of now, I don't see a Tamil language, but they will definitely add those books. And this is actually India website don't they don't put any kind of raw data in or any kind of PDF file. They don't upload. They have just create a link. If you go with this click on this, they will directly transfer to their website. In this is the Wikisource page. Actually, they are opening to the their website with a Wikisource. Not their they are not transferring the whole page, but they are into the NDLA page. They are showing this page. This is the Wikisource article, or this is a Wikisource book, and anyone can read, anyone can copy and paste, and that's their motto. They are not uploading any kind of PDF files or any kind of anything. They are just create one link with there and create a basic metadata. That's their main purpose. That's collaboration with our final output. Day by day, they will adding the more books in form of Wikisource. That's it. And I think next in initial, this is my presentation.
Okay, thank you. Yes. Thank you, Jayanta. இவர் குறிப்பாக சொல்றதுல பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, இவங்களுடைய கண்டென்ட்டை தேசிய நூலகமாக எடுத்து பயன்படுத்துகிறாங்க. நீங்கள் விக்கிசோர்ஸில் கான்ட்ரிபியூஷன் பண்ணுறதும் மாதிரியும், விக்கிசோர்ஸில் இருக்கக்கூடிய கண்டென்ட்டை இப்போ நீங்கள் ஏதாவது ஒரு லைப்ரரி இல்லாத ஒரு வெப்சைட் கிரியேட் பண்ணால் கூட அதிலே நீங்கள் எடுத்து யூஸ் பண்ணிக்கலாம். அதில் ஒரு பெஸ்ட் எக்ஸாம்பிள் தான் இப்போ நீங்கள் பார்த்தது. ஸோ இந்தியன் டிஜிட்டல் லைப்ரரி கூட வந்து இவங்க கண்டென்ட் எடுத்து யூஸ் பண்ணிக்கிட்டு இருக்காங்க. ஸோ அந்த எக்ஸாம்பிள் நிறையா சொன்னார். இது பொதுவாக டிஜிட்டலைசேஷனுக்கு ஆக்டாக வரக்கூடிய ப்ராஜெக்ட் தான் விக்கிசோர்ஸ். So is there any other question regarding these two discussion? Because these people will leave soon. They have other commitments at 3 o'clock. So Nazar Khan, sir, do you have any other question?
Yes. So the first the speaker spoke about land mapping projects, like we see told, you know. And can we have some more ideas about it, or
So GLAM is basically, I have explained, galleries, libraries, archives and museums. So such GLAM institutions are there around us. So if you take one district and you can list the GLAM institutions taking data from the government and taking data from various trusts or the research organizations working on them, and then you can like make the groups of students, and you can assign them some part of the GLAM institutions. Like every student can visit 5 institutions, and he can share the Wikimedia projects with them. We can train them in showing the Wikimedia Commons, how the books are uploaded, how the images are uploaded, how the galleries are created on Wikimedia Commons of various objects and paintings, etc. So how to make all the knowledge digital or the online, this small training, small presentation we can make. I can share my presentation in Marathi or English with you. You can make it in Tamil and or English. And
English
then,
is preferable.
Preferable. The students can share these projects with them, and they can explore the like possibility of bringing their knowledge into Wikimedia. So such kind of projects, I think confidence of student will also increase. They will also learn about some of the things, what the metadata is, how the cataloging is done in the libraries, what is the COHA, what is the universal cataloging, what is the universal cataloging, how the systems are changing in library. So such kind of, so we can give these assignments to mass communication and journalism, as well as the library if BLIB or the MLIB students are there. So, or we can match this with any student, of course, history or political science, arts students also can join these activities. So, GLAM mapping we can take up, and CISA2K can support in training. Then with collaboration also we will support. We will come to some of the major institutions and we can have dialogue with them. Like that, we can focus on one or two districts in the beginning. And then in next year, we can expand that activity to other districts. We can focus on one city also. Like if we focus on Chennai, then also it is worth to map the institutions.
Okay.
And people, students can be given assignment to create article on that institution in Wikipedia. So in Tamil Wikipedia, they can create article on that gallery or library or museum.
This is important one, because assignments to the students you are talking about, you know, assignments. Especially you gave us an example like mass media student, you said. So ours is completely, medical and paramedical students and engineering colleges there. So if it is a dental college or a pharmacy college or nursing college, how can we give assignments to such students? Because how can we make them involved in that area?
So that's why the partnerships are needed. We cannot restrict to our own institution for knowledge creation. So there may be some good laboratory with some institution where the artifacts are there, where the all the models are there. So we can photograph those models and we can create small articles about the urinary system or the. So there is a large scope to create the articles, because the science related articles and the media is missing in the language Wikipedias. So media is missing. So we can photograph or videograph the models of various anatomy and other things, and we can document them in Wikipedia. So everything can be integrated with the academic assignment. So we have to develop rules where how many references should be there per article, how many images should be there per article. So if we come up with good article criteria, then we can assign every student to create that article, and we can keep watch on timeline also. Like there is a history in Wikipedia page, so we can keep watching the how he is contributing. Is he contributing regularly, or on the last day he copy paste the material? Everything can be assessed in the wiki page. So 2 years back, one Solapur University, they took up one assignment to document all the newspapers during the Indian independence struggle. And there were nearly 40 plus very good articles created by the students going through all the old papers, old references. Then they found that one library is there in Solapur, Hirachan Nemchan, which is having all the newspapers during the Indian independence struggle. So they went to that library, and the students were so motivated and they were so involved in all those newspapers. So till night they were sitting there for 2-3 days. They were sitting there going through all the newspapers and other things. So it was a treasure for them to see the newspapers 100 years back during the independence struggle. So such kind of enthusiasm can be created among the students if we expose them to such knowledge repositories around us.
Okay.
So we can
thank you.
This.
Yes.
We can discuss this. We can have a special meeting on this afterwards.
Surely, certainly we do. We are running really out of time, and there are more speakers are waiting for us.
Yes.
And
yes,
thank
yes.
you, Mr. Subodh. Thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you, Subodh.
We are leaving, we will be meeting soon for special meetings or focus meetings.
Let's talk. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So now we have Gaurav from Punjabi Wikipedia. Gaurav, are you ready to speak? Let me share my screen.
Yes, Nilchari, I'm
Yes,
ready.
yes. Let, okay.
Okay.
Sharing the screen.
Am I audible?
Yes, Gaurav, you're audible.
Okay. Hello, everyone. Myself, Gaurav Jambat from Punjabi Wikipedia, Punjabi community. Today, I'm talking on the behalf of Punjabi Wikimedians, our user group. Our user group registered in 2015-16, and in this session today talk, I'm going to talk about our user group collaborations or partnership outreach program, whatever we have done in this period. Majorly, we talk about all the project, Wiki project, our big, more collaboration programs are under Wikipedia. So, I have classified that collaboration into two parts, major collaboration and small collaboration. Major collaboration, our biggest or most successful collaboration, if I say, it's with the Punjabi University, Patiala. It's a university in Patiala in Punjab. And that university is constructed on the name of a language, and it's constructed for the promotion of language and literature. So we have a collaboration with them, with the Department of Punjabi. They recommend their students to upload their semesterly assignments on the Wikipedia and the proper Wiki format and proper Wiki text formatting references. So these are good for Wiki environment, because on the one point, these articles or these assignments are very useful for the students who are studying masters of Punjabi or generally who love to read literary articles or language articles. So first of one point, these articles are useful, and second thing, they are creating the standard articles and active and some good quality contributors. So there is one collaboration we have, and the second one is Siba School. It's in Lahra Gagga Sangrur, also in Punjab. And there is our one Wikimedian named Jaksir. He was working there in school. Actually, this was the India's, I think, first school who designed its Wiki syllabus. So they designed the syllabus all according to Wiki project, and they hired a Wikimedian or as a computer teacher, so he can teach their students a computer as well as Wiki training. So he worked here for a year, and when pandemic corona started, he has to leave that job. But in that year, he trained the students to Wikipedia, Wiki Commons, and Wikidata. The students created articles on Wikipedia in that year. They uploaded pics on Commons, and they also created a book on Wikisource for learning Punjabi, Aao Punjabi Sikhiye, which I can say English in Let's Learn Punjabi. So this book is now available on Punjabi Wikisource as well as audio format. And our one collaboration is also Chandigarh Group of Colleges, CGC Landra, where our Wiki National Conference organized. So actually, there was our one Wikimedian, Harpreet Sandhu, was the faculty member in that institute at that time. So the institute collaborated very well with us, and they cooperated with every session, every moment of the conference. So in the last one, all the communities saw that the conference was happening very well organized. So Catherine Mayer, or the former CEO of Wikimedia Foundation, also appreciated that organization. So that was our collaborator. And for okay, there are three more education institutes we are collaborating with institute of the NRGCC College Khanna and Calicut. His group actually there were we invested a lot, like we run an awareness program there, we run a training sessions, online sessions, and program were running very good. They had a proper trainer or computer teacher. Actually we trained their teachers or computer teachers so they can teach their students or they can solve their queries if students have any problem in Wikipedia, like reference or wiki text, or they have any template error. So the computer teacher was solving their queries. But what happened at the pandemic times, that trainer lost his job and he went to search for a new one. So lack of coordination and technical support, students have stopped that enthusiasm and wiki editing. In GCG College Khanna, we run a Wikipedia awareness seminar and workshop also we organized, and there was no any particular trainer or wiki vegan who was training regularly, but we trained some students, and then that students were training their juniors or some other students. But in pandemic time, that program closed. And there also is a Khanna Academy School. It's actually government funded institution. This education program we are running here is not at much very big level, but they run a monthly wiki activity once in a month, and they create wiki articles, the stuff. So that were our bigger collaborations with the education institutions, but we have some small collaborations also. I will just name there: Punjab University, Chandigarh, Modi College, Patiala, Sangrur, Acorn School in Sangrur. I am saying these institutions collaborations small because we have just conducted one workshop here, and we were but we have not received long-term result what we expected from that workshop, because we have not any regular Wikimedian there to take follow-ups or feedback or to check if they have any students have any problems or if they want to train or get any training further. So other than Wikipedia, we have some collaborations with some institutes or some writers who have donated their books to Wikisource under free public use. Some writers like Gurbakh Singh Frank or Ram Sarupan Kiriyal Sahib Academy awardees, and they donated their all books to Wikisource. These are some of our communities, educational institutes collaborations, but in addition we have some problems, we have some challenges, like all the institutes almost we have some Wikimedian working there, or we have any Wikipedian who were there to check what was happening there, or what were their problems if in editing or to take follow-up. But when the pandemic happened or something other thing happened, we didn't have no Wikimedian in that institutions, the collaboration stopped, or the wiki editing or contribution stopped. So that was our one challenge that we wanted some regular Wikimedians who, because this problem is due to our Wikimedians are students, so they have their regular study or job issue, so they can't invest their whole time into that Wiki training or Wiki workshops. So our challenges are that institutions from backward from institutions, some our follow-up programs, like we need some regular equity meetings. And our one problem also that we I had told in the early that in Punjabi University Patiala we are running education program and they are creating wiki assignments on the Wikipedia, but we don't have any Wikimedian, or we don't review that assignments or current document of that assignment, so we didn't know the exactly count of how much is assignment they have uploaded till the date, because if there is a tool name, I have heard dashboard, but dashboard count up a limited time contribution, but they upload the assignment the whole semester or the whole year, so we can't run a dashboard tool here, so we have a reviewer or documentation problem in that program, so facing that. Otherwise, if I summarize all the my talk, Punjabi community still has no problem in collaboration or face-to-face conversation with the educational institute. Nothing problem in student training, but we have face some problems if we haven't trained any teachers or a bigger level institution so that they can train their students at their own level. So we are expecting to do that thing if we can do work collaborations at that level. Thank you.
Thank you, Gaurav. Let me stop sharing. டு சம்மரைஸ் இன் தமிழ், உங்கள் குறிப்பாக வந்து சில கல்லூரிகளில் வந்து முழுநேர பணியாளர்களே வந்து விக்கிபீடியா வந்து பணியமர்த்துச்சு. இப்போ உதாரணத்துக்கு உங்கள் கல்லூரியில் யாருக்காவது வந்து இதில் ஆர்வம் இருக்குது, ஒரு மாணவர்களுக்கு ஆர்வம் இருக்குது, ஒரு 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 செஷனே எடுக்கணும்னு நினச்சிங்கன்னா ஒரு முழுநேர பணியாளரே வந்து சிஎஸ் வந்து உங்களுக்கு கொடுப்பாங்க. அவங்க வந்து முழுக்க விக்கிபீடியா சம்மந்தப்பட்ட ஒரு பயிற்சியை வந்து டிபார்ட்மெண்ட் வைஸாக கிளாஸ் வைஸாக கூட எடுத்திருக்காங்க. அந்த மாதிரி கூட சில பள்ளிகளுக்கு பண்ணியிருக்காங்க, அரசு பள்ளிகளுக்கு. அதில் சில சிக்கல்கள் இருந்து அவங்க பணி மாறினதுக்கப்புறம் வந்து அதை எடுத்துகிட்டு போக முடியாமல் போயிடுச்சு. குறிப்பாக அந்த மாணவர்கள் வந்து அந்த மாதிரி கரெக்ஷன்ஸ் எல்லாம் வந்து அந்த மாணவர்கள் பண்ணுறப்ப வந்து அவங்களால வந்து அந்த அகடமிக்கல் ஸ்கில்ஸை வந்து வளர்த்துக்க முடியுது அப்படின்றத இவரோட அனுபவத்தில் நம்ம தெரிஞ்சுக்க முடியுது. ஓகே, தேங்க்யூ கௌரவ். வி வில் இன்வைட் அஸ்வின்.
Gaurav's talk is over. Yes, Gaurav, do you have anything more to say? I thought your question session is still left.
No, sir. I have ended my talk. If any question, if anyone can ask.
Okay, thank you, Gaurav. Ashwin, you can take the
floor. Okay. First of all, I'd like to say namaste. I don't have any Tamil, but I only know two words, nalla irke. So I hope it means something. And I hope that all of you are well, especially in these times of COVID. And it is my pleasure to be here with all the teachers and other distinguished staff of the KKN University. And I would like to build up on what my colleagues have already told you. Now, as regards what my colleagues have been telling you, the first two people who spoke, Mr. Subodh and Mr. Jayantanath, they are part of the initiative called Center for Internet and Society Access to Knowledge. And they spoke about their programs. And then they were part of the formal movement in the sense that they were a part of the Wikimedia Foundation directly or indirectly. The next presentation was by my friend Gaurav Jamman, who is a volunteer. And he explained his community's efforts in collaboration. And you got the idea of how a community carries out collaboration. Now, I have deliberately chosen, based on what I have listened to them, to take in a slightly different direction, because I think you have got enough guidance on the scope of activities and how a community can organize itself for collaboration. And I am moving towards a different topic, that is to give you some guidance on how to organize an online collaboration on Wikipedia. Unfortunately, since I have no Tamil and I'm active only on English Wikipedia, I will be conducting my talk fully in English with English slides. And I will also show you some Wikipedia pages of English Wikipedia pertaining to my subject. However, like I mentioned, this is just an introduction. Don't worry if you cannot understand all the complicated, you know, sometimes the stuff on the screen looks complicated because you have never seen it before. And because the concepts and everything is strange and new. Just try to understand the mool, that is the crux, that is the, important thing that I'm trying to say. And if you understand, that's more than enough. In the future, I'm available for any help that anybody requires. I have given my contact details for that right away. Oh, I forgot to introduce myself to all of you. Unfortunately, there are 63 people at the moment. There were 75 people at one time. So I would just like to say that my name is Colonel Ashwin Bendur. I'm a retired army officer. I've been a Wikipedian since 2006. And I've been working with the Indian community at various places. But basically, my activities have been on Wiki Project India. That is the small community on English Wikipedia, which is looking after the articles on subjects pertaining to India. So that is my main background. I've also been involved with teaching editors how to edit and give a lot of these kind of skills on how to function on Wikipedia proper, English Wikipedia, of course, in my case. And from that background, I now come and present to you how to organize an online drive. I feel qualified for this because I've conducted some online drives myself. And I will be telling you first the principles of how to conduct an online drive. And then I will show you some Wikipedia pages pertaining to a drive that we conducted in 2012. And why I'm showing you such an old one is because since then our drives, have the pages of that drive or that this thing are not so visible. So it would be harder to explain. But this was one of our most successful drive. About 80,000 articles got assessed in that. And then and I will explain this whole thing to you. Aim is not to teach you how to do the same drive in your language. Aim is only to illustrate the principles of organizing a drive. That's all. It may sound a little involved, but don't worry. If you go step by step, carefully thinking out everything will fall into place. It's quite easy. It's much easier than people think. So now, with the permission of Nichal Karan, I will start presenting.
Sure.
That share button is not coming. Do you need to give me some kind of a permission for that? Entire screen. Can you see? Is my screen shared? Hello? It's not sharing for some reason. It says cancel and then, this is giving an option with cancel and share. But in the share button is depressed and I cannot press it because it's not there. And even if I'm pressing, it's not sharing.
No, I hope we all have access. Or else you can mail me. I will share in my screen.
Okay. What acha? Okay. I'll what's your email ID?
Nichalkaran@gmail.com. Let me put in comment.
Yeah. Because I'll need to share it on the Google Doc. How do I share this? Okay, escape. Share. I'm also providing the link here to that document. It is on at the moment. So anyone who would like to see that way, and please save it, feel free to save it. It's just a list of points. So you can do that and let me know. Nichal, can you yes, share that?
Asking for access. I just clicked it.
Oh, wow. Okay, an email. Okay, yeah, one second. Okay.
I think you can share that file public.
Sorry?
Right now the file is not with public access.
Okay. Viewers can okay share with people settings. Get a link restricted. Oh, no, only. Okay, one sec. Anyone with a link. Yeah, done. Just see, check okay. Now, I think. Updated
yes,
it to public.
Yes, I can.
And I've also now, given you permission both ways.
Okay. Let me share the screen.
To reduce the this thing for a moment, I will just switch off. Can everybody see? Can everybody see?
Yes, sir, we can.
Thank you. Okay. Now, the point what I'd like to say is that in the beginning, before you do, coming to the backdrop, y'all are, I'm assuming that y'all are teachers and academic staff, and you would like to carry out some kind of a Wikipedia project in which some activity is done by the students. And that student, with those students, you'd like to do it, say, maybe this, though this was made for a GLAM collaboration, it can be for any collaboration, online collaboration in Wikipedia. So I will just tell you the steps which are required so that you have at least some guidance to begin it rather than wondering what to do. If you follow these steps, you will roughly get everything right. So the first thing that you decide is what is your purpose? Because people, if they are not clear of their purpose, you can, you find out that you made a collaboration and then your collaboration is gone in one direction and your intention, original intention was something. So what is your purpose? So let us say that your purpose is maybe for young students to learn to write Wikipedia articles. Okay. So you should be clear about that. So all your activities has to be focused on that. The purpose may be different for another person. Another person may be wanting that the heritage of their city should be saved. So he'll want photographs of the monuments and important, visit places to visit or tourism places or heritage places to be stored on, say, Wikimedia Commons, where we put up images for all Wikipedias. You have to be very clear for your purpose. It's easy to decide your purpose, but you must decide that first. After that, the next step naturally comes, which Wikimedia project shall I use? If my aim is for my students to learn how to edit any Wikipedia articles, to understand using Wikipedia or anything related to Wikipedia, naturally we have to use Wikipedia of the particular language that is involved. But suppose you want to do anything with English or with media, like saving videos or saving sound files or images, or then you would need to use the project called as Wikimedia Commons. If you are interested in developing a collaborative project where certain knowledge is put and certain multimedia is put, you can use Wikibooks, in which you can make some kind of a textbook or a report in which all these students are collaborating there and publish it there. On the other hand, if you have got in your library, in your institution, maybe a set of old books that you want to, or old pamphlets that you want to put up for making it available to the community rather being that, and you want the students to help with that. And while they are doing that, they will learn about heritage, they will learn about scanning, they will learn the standards, the software which is involved, what are the problems faced, how to organize such a project and other source, then you'll require Wikisource. Now, you will have seen that there are these projects, all these projects have been used in the various ventures which have been mentioned by distinguished colleagues before. So that's that. So you have to decide based on what you need. The next thing that's important is, if you're planning an online collaboration using a Wikipedia, the most important thing is volunteers. That means you have to have people who are going to volunteer. Now, normally, if you are an academic institution, your volunteers are already there, such as your students. But it also may be that sometime you may want to organize an event which is not for your students, but which is for the general public, which you are organizing on behalf of the college and providing this. But the volunteer, that means the participants are not, ready-made and fixed with you like students are. So in that case, you have to make this, you have to decide this very carefully, that who are these volunteers, what are their motivation, what are their rewards, why would they want to collaborate with you? And if you understand and you have a solution to this, that yes, I will ask the people of this city to volunteer in giving their photographs. For example, suppose you belong to Pondicherry and you want to put up all the images of the monuments of Pondicherry, then you can ask all the people of Pondicherry. So then you have to know where, how to contact them, what words to use to motivate them, what are the, why they would feel like participating, and how, what kind of rewards that you will offer. In the case of online collaboration in Wikimedia, when rewards, we don't mean cash rewards or presents or gifts, but we do provide in the Wikimedia world rewards in the form of achievements or tokens that is there. For example, a person who, as suppose he has created 10 articles, then we can give him some kind of a symbol which he can display on his page. Those symbols, for historical reasons, on English Wikipedia are called as barn stars. I'll type that term in the chat, barn star. It's just because in the West, they used to put some decoration on the barn, which was in the shape of a star. So that became used as a symbol. So you'll find that in Wikimedia community, in English Wikipedia, anyone has got some achievement, it will be in the form of a barn star, or it will be in the form of a medal. Usually. I'll show you examples of these also. And what happens is that you say, okay, if you do, say, 10 articles, then I will give you 10, I will give you a bronze barn star. If you do 100 articles, I'll give you silver barn star. And if you do 500 articles, I'll give you gold barn star. And the person who has come first, he will get a medal. You know, all these are images and these are publicly announced, that such and such person has got this medal or barn star. And only that person can display that, who has been awarded that barn star. That means if I have not been given a barn star, I can't go and put it up on my this thing. Otherwise, everybody will laugh at me and say, what a person, he's a liar. He has not done anything and he is showing off these things, you know, falsely that way. So it's a honor code. So we have these rewards. There are other ways of rewards also. For example, in the case, I'll give one example. in the case of an offline activity. You understand offline? Offline means real world. Online means on the internet, using the internet, using Wikipedia projects and all. In case, in a certain museum where they were doing collaboration, those people who participated, they got a special day at the museum where they did not have to be paid tickets. They were taken around and they were not only allowed to see whatever was there in the museum, they were even given access to the stuff which is in the stores. Now, this was announced as the reward and it was so motivating because the things in that museum were so, you know, important and so hard to see that a lot of people got motivated and participated. So that was a very good reward. So anything which motivates your people, or maybe it is a felicitation in public in a function by some VIP, that can also be done. So no matter what you do, you have to choose your, you have to understand what motivates the people. You have to use those motivations and you must give them adequate reward. Can you please push this up, please? Next thing for planning a drive. Okay. This steps, I will explain these steps to you, is planning, and this is an online drive on Wikipedia or Wikimedia Commons or something. You have now done, the, you know, thought about this. You decided you want to do an online collaboration event. You decided you want to do it, say, let's say Wikipedia, and now you want to plan the drive. So the steps are, first is you have to plan the event. And in the planning of the event, you have to think of all these things. So the first thing that is there is that you have, you know, though this is written in sequence, actually the first thing that you want to do is, how will the participants work? That means, what is it that they have to do and how will they do it? So what they have to do is that you have to think that, okay, participant will create an article. So, and if he creates an article, he must add that article in a list of his name under a place at a particular place. And that article must meet these criteria. It must have at least 500 words. It must have at least 2 images and it must have at least 5 references. So when this kind of, you know, you're clear that this is what a person has to do to participate, then you can go about doing the next thing. That is to get publicity and including social media to announce. Now, this can be as little as announcing on a, you know, on a user group on Wikipedia. I'm showing a link there to y'all. In the talk page, this is the announcement that we once made for a particular. Sorry. This is a wrong one. My apologies. One second. Yeah, this is. Yeah, here you are. This is the link. This link. Yeah, so this was the announcement on an English Wikipedia for the particular problem. Now, before we go into this announcement, I want to tell you what the problem was that we had decided. In Wikipedia, in English Wikipedia, we have something like 1 lakh articles. And in those 1 lakh articles, or rather in that time, we were just below 1 lakh, about 18,000 of these articles were not assessed. Now, when I talk of what assessment means, anyone can write an article. But there are 2 things about an article that English Wikipedia allows you to do. It allows you to know what is the quality of that article and what is the importance of that article. So, for example, I'm giving a link now. here. This is an article which is on today's front page of English Wikipedia called Cressy Campaign. Don't bother with what the article is. But what is the quality of this article? So if you look on the right corner, go up. On the right corner, you'll see a golden star. You can shut off the banner, Mitchell. You can see a golden star. That star indicates that this is the highest quality of article in English Wikipedia. And this is, you know, there are various grades of article. So we have something which is called a stub, something which is a beginning article with three lines, a start article which has got 3-4 paragraphs, maybe one image, one reference, then something which is called C class. That means article is there, but nobody has assessed it for quality. B class, someone has taken a C class article and assessed it over a 5-point checklist. And based on that, if the checklist requirement is not managed, it has been made, okay as per that 5-point checklist. Then it is said, array, this is a B class article. Then we have something called A class, which is there in very few places, where what happens in the case of A class articles, you do a check to see that anything and everything as far as the content is correct and there are no things which are unnecessary or missing. So that is a kind of quality check. Everyone doesn't do it, but it is there. And if it is done, it's called an A class article. And after that, then the best articles in Wikipedia are there in two levels. One is called as a good article in GA. It has got a reasonable and every article, everyone should try to reach at least that level. And then if you are really want to show quality work, the best of the best, the jewel of the this thing, you can take your article and ask people to check it out and point out all and every mistake. And my God, they are very thorough in finding mistakes. And you have to set them right. And if they feel, yes, you have done a good job, then there is a team which says, okay, we accept your submission. We agree that you have this is a good article. You have listened to all our points and satisfied them. So it is now a featured article. But the point what happens is when an article is newly created, it is not stub, start, A, B, C or good article or featured article. Nobody knows what it is. So at that point of time, what happens is it has to be assessed. That means someone has to go to the article and say that this article is C class or it is only a start article or it is a B class article and say so. Now, that requires some editor to go and assess that article. Alongside that, there is another parameter called importance. Now, for example, I will show you a particular article from Indian Wikipedia, which is,
Ashwini, we have sorry. A few minutes, 3:30, we are going to wind this call, so you can rush up.
Okay.
Sorry to disturb you. Oh, yes.
Okay, fine. Sorry, I have taken much longer than I thought. So anyway, in that case, what we'll do is, we'll go on to the other points. I'll leave this issue. You know, the depth at which I'm explaining, I can continue to explain in a separate session for anybody who's interested. You can get in touch with Mr. Nichal Karan. It'll take about an hour or so, and I'll explain like that. But I'll explain these points as we go quickly. So after you get this thing, you have the aim. Now, aim is, that means in this drive, what do you plan to achieve? I plan to achieve 500 articles created. I plan to achieve 1,000 images upload. So then you have to calculate the results. And sometimes what happens, you may find that there is less this thing. So you say, what is the end point? So I say, okay, in 30 days, what have we achieved? That is the end point. Or if we reach 500, we will end there. Or if people are still willing to go beyond 500, we'll end wherever we reach after 30 days, beyond that 500, that way. After that, then you will need to plan the various pages about the competition on Wikimedia. I can show them to you, but since there is less time and it's a little complicated, we will not be able to do so. The next thing that we've already decided how the participants can work, But what happens is when a participant comes, he doesn't know what to do. So you have to write guides or frequently ask questions for them so that they understand, even if it is a simple thing as adding an image to Commons, how to do it. Because many of the people who will participate, want to participate, but are not Wikimedians, they don't know what to do. So you will provide that. And then you will give the rewards or a recommendation. I'll just show you like the rewards or recommendation slide. You can have a look, quick look. You can just click on this, Nikhil, Karan. Yeah, so these are the rewards that we had used. They were so anyone who achieved any of these got to show this on his user page. And actually, here are the three medals that we have given to the people who won it. So so these three medals, gold, silver, and bronze. And we gave them in two groups for experienced Wikipedians and people who are brand new Wikipedians. So that both types of editors got recognition. For brand new Wikipedian, that means if you just joined Wikipedia, the standards were lower. But if you are experienced, the standards were extremely high. That's it. Yeah, can we go back to the Google Doc? Yeah, so then you conduct the event and complete the activities. Next, come down, please. In the conduct of the event, certain steps are there. You have to make the announcement on a social media. I've shown you an example. There must be a place where people can write their name and then they join. And as per the guide or instructions that you gave, they will start participating. So once they participated and they come and tell you, okay, in 10 days I've made these articles, so there must be a place to write either the number of articles or where they can show what articles they've written or which images they've drawn. And you keep reporting the progress to the community. Now, this is important because, for example, on English Wikipedia, in the Wiki Project India, people, the moment we started reporting that today 500 people have done and the person who has put most articles today is such and such with 45 articles. So then, you know, people go, we found suddenly that number of people who got, you know, recruiting in the middle and late stage also continued. They got enthused. They say something is going on. I want to be part of that event. And afterwards, we completed the event and then we announced the results and rewards. And the visit of important pages, I had planned to show these to you. But that there is no time now. It is almost 1 minute left only. I will show this to you on some other day on this thing. But this is the name of the, and I'll leave the link here of that particular project page of that competition. Even if you see it, you will get some idea, some kind of a, what you call, guidance about it. So that's the link which is there. And if you just click it, we can just show it to the people without doing anything much about it.
Is this one?
Just let it be on and okay. We won't spend any time, but okay. I just want to show the page.
Which one? The last one, right?
Last one.
Okay.
Yeah. So this is it. 2012. Can you just go down, please? Just keep scrolling down. So there are various places, special awards, names for participation, go on and on, you know, edit 1,000 edits, tips, collective scorecard, drive. And here is where we were keeping tag. We had made, this is what is called a dashboard. And then someone wanted to say individual tally. We want to report our individual progress. So someone made this table. So they did that also. That means basically they're giving themselves tasks and that sort of thing and all. So it went on. Let's go right to the bottom. It's longish. Just scroll fast. So we were successful. And this is actually the pages of the statistics where we had done. And we had done that. And we had announced the results also, as you saw in the medals. So a lot of work was done. And it was done like this. Now, I'll just take one question so that you don't feel that there. I'm here. Okay, you can continue to speak for next half an hour. But you have probably you may have to close the event or people may have to leave. So I'll just take one question. Does anybody have a question? Fine. I understand. All of this is, you know, been given, you know, very in a compact, far too concentrated a dose. But the point what I'm trying to say is it is possible to make a long event, a large event in which 200 people participated, and it developed progressively. It was not that we had this whole idea and suddenly this thing developed. And as we felt the need, we kept on adding elements to it. And we achieved this event. In the final event, we had tagged 80,000 articles, tagged and assessed 80,000 articles. So it was a great success in 2012. It happened by Indians. It was not a language community such as Telugu or Tamil committee. It was unfortunately, it was, or rather, it happened to be the English Indians who were working on English Wikipedia, but they are also a community and they had done it. I have given my contact details. I have given these links. So I think I'm not sure whether these links can be saved and shared. Do you have an etherpad for this event, Nichal?
No, but I will make a copy and I will share it with these people.
Yes, please. So from my side, I have finished. I'm sorry I could not be part of your earlier instruction before this. That was due to some prior commitments. But I'm very happy that to get this chance to have spoken to you and give you at least some guidance. So I understand that this is not adequate. And I do understand that you'll have a lot of questions. It's okay if you're not going to do these events. But if you do these events and you find, and if you keep this list and you, if you think on these lines, you'll surely, you know, reach, you'll have some guidance as opposed to zero guidance. And once you decided these things, if you call me on the phone or on email and we speak, I may be able to help you to resolve any issues that you face and also to give you some suggestions, which I hope would be constructive. So from my side, I give you a belated welcome to the Wikimedia movement. And I thank you for listening to me so patiently. 63 people are listening. This is one of the largest set groups of people who have listened. And I'm most grateful.
Thank you, Ashwin. Also, we have a few more participants are viewing in YouTube as well. Okay, and also thank you for your time as well.
Okay, in that case, I would just like to say hello to all those on YouTube. Thank you. I'm not sure whether you will be able to get the details which is there on the chat here. But if you are watching on YouTube and you want the information, please get in touch with the user Nichal Karan. And I'm sure he will provide all the details so that you can get in touch with me. I'm user Ashlin, A-S-H-L-I-N on English Wikipedia. A is capital, L is capital. And the reason for that name is because I sometimes use Linux. And one of my friends, he said, you must not be called Ashwin because Ashwin and Windows. So he doesn't like Windows. So he said Ashlin. With Linux, so that's the name, that's why it is there. So I thank you, and with this I will complete my talk. Thank you so much once again.
Thank you, Ashwin. Hopefully we may expect you for a larger session, like a complete session with the same institution maybe in future.
Yeah.
Thank you. Nazir Khan.
Yes,
இவர் குறிப்பா நீங்க உங்க ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸை வச்சு எழுதாம கூட நீங்க வந்து ஒரு 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 ஆர்கனைசரா இருக்கா இப்ப எப்படி ஒரு டோக்கியோ ஒலிம்பிக்க வந்து ஏதாவது ஒரு ஒரு பர்டிகுலர் கண்ட்ரி வந்து அதை வந்து ஆர்கனைஸ் பண்றாங்களோ அதே மாதிரி கூட ஒரு ஈவெண்ட்டை நீங்களே கூட ஹோஸ்ட் பண்ணலாம் நீங்க வந்து பப்ளிக்கா மக்களை வந்து கூப்பிட்டு நீங்க ஆர்கனைஸ் பண்ணி அந்த ஏதாவது ஒரு ஈவெண்ட் உங்களுக்கு பிடிச்ச டாபிக்ல ஸோ அதான் உங்க டீம் என்ன அப்படின்ற முன்னாடி முடிவு பண்ணிக்கலாம் அதே மாதிரி என்ன மாதிரி டீம்ல செய்ய போறோம் ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் இப்போ பேராமெடிக்கல் இல்லை மெடிசனோ அப்படி எடுத்தீங்கன்னா மெடிசனில் கூட ஏதாவது ஒரு ப்ராஜெக்டை நீங்களே கூட முடிவு பண்ணலாம் எது விக்கிபீடியாவில் இல்லையோ அதை எடுத்து எல்லா காலேஜஸ்க்கும் எடுத்து ஒரு ஒரு ஆர்கனைஸ் பண்ணி ஒரு ஈவெண்ட்டை கூட இனிஷியேட் பண்ணலாம் அதை எப்படி குவான்டிஃபை பண்ணலாம் எப்படி மெஷர் பண்ணலாம் அதை எப்படி குவாலிட்டியாக ஸ்டார்ஸ் கொடுத்து அதை ரெகக்னைஸ் பண்ணலாம் அப்படின்றதுலாம் கூட நீங்க பாத்துப்பீங்க. கட்டா இந்த செஷன் பத்தாது, பட் இது ஒரு ஓவர்வியூ கிடைச்சிருக்கும். இப்படிலாம் இருக்கு அப்படின்னு ஒரு ஐடியா கிடைச்சிருக்கும். மேபி ஃபியூச்சர்ல வந்து டைம் இருந்துச்சுன்னா ஒரு என்டையர் செஷனை கூட அஸ்மின் வச்சு பண்ணலாம்,
பண்ணிக்கலாம்.
சோ அதெல்லாம் ஒரு ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டி.
ரொம்ப ரொம்ப ஷார்ட்டா தான் ஒரு டைம் இல்ல, எங்கனால ஒரு கட கட முடிச்சிட்டாரு நினைக்கிறேன்
சார்.
நோட்டபிலிட்டியும் அந்த இம்பார்ட்டன்ஸும் இருந்தா போதும். அந்த குவாலிட்டி இருக்கணும். நீங்க ஏதாவது ஒரு ஆர்டிகல் கிரியேட் பண்றீங்கன்னா அந்த ஆர்டிகல் குவாலிட்டியா இருக்கணும். அந்த டாபிக் வந்து
ஆர்டிகல்ஸ் தான் சார். இப்ப ரிவ்யூ ஆர்டிகல் ரிசர்ச் அப்படின் இருக்கு இல்லீங்களா? சோ அப்போ அந்த எந்த மாதிரி ஆர்டிகல்ஸ், இப்ப எந்த ஆர்டிகல்ஸா இருந்தாலும் எவ்வளவு நமக்கு ஃபீட்பேக் வருது அந்த இது இருக்கோ அதை பத்தி அசஸ்மெண்ட் இருக்காங்க சார்.
ஆமா, அதாவது ஃபீட்பேக் பொறுத்து கிடையாது. ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், நோட்டபிலிட்டி அப்படின்ற ஒரு பாலிசி இருக்கு. இப்ப நேற்று செஷன்ல கூட உங்களுக்கு லிங்க் காட்டியிருக்கேன். ஆமா, எது எழுதலாம் எது எழுதக்கூடாதுன்னு இருக்கும். இப்ப ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், நீங்க வந்து இப்ப உங்களை பத்தி எழுதுறாம்னா எழுத முடியாது, ஆனா ஒரு பர்டிகுலர் தியரியை பத்தி எழுதுறாம்னா கட்டாயம் எழுதலாம். சரியா? அந்த மாதிரி நீங்க நோட்டபிலிட்டி கூடிய விஷயம், அதுக்கு ரெஃபரன்ஸ் நீங்க கொடுக்கணும். அப்ப ரெஃபரன்ஸ் இருக்கிற மாதிரியான தீம்ஸ் நீங்க எடுக்கணும். நீங்க ஏதாவது ஒரு ரொம்ப ரேரான ஒரு ரிசர்ச் பண்ணா கூட அதுக்கான ரெஃபரன்ஸ் இல்ல, அது உங்களுடைய ஓன் ரிசர்ச்சா இருந்துச்சுன்னா அதை அங்க பப்ளிஷ் பண்ண முடியாது. சோ அந்த மாதிரி கிரைட்டீரியா தான் எனக்கு தவிர, எந்த டாபிக்ல வேணாலும் எடுத்து எழுதலாம். இம்பார்ட்டன்ஸ் இருக்கு அப்படின்னா நீங்க தாராளமா எடுத்துக்கலாம். நீங்க வந்து தீம் வந்து உங்களுக்கு பிடிச்ச மாதிரி, இப்ப ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் நீங்க ஏதாவது ஒரு ஃபீல்ட்ல இருக்கீங்கன்னா அந்த ஃபீல்டு சம்பந்தமான ஒரு தீம் வச்சீங்கன்னா உங்களுக்கு அது இன்ட்ரெஸ்டா இருக்கும். நீங்க அதை எடுத்துட்டு போறதுல உங்களுக்கு ஒரு சாட்டிஸ்பேக்ஷன் இருக்கும். சோ அதுதான் சொல்றமே தவிர வேற எங்க லிமிடேஷன் இருக்கு.
பட் நம்ம வந்து இப்போ அந்த இதையே வந்து விக்கிமீடியா அதை வந்து நம்ம கேட்டகரைஸ் பண்ணிக்கலாமா சார்? இல்லத்துக்கு எக்ஸ்க்ளூசிவ்லி ஃபார் டென்டலுக்கு தனியா
பண்ணிக்கலாம்,
அந்த மாதிரி பண்ணிக்கலாம் இல்லீங்களா?
பண்ணிக்கலாம். இன்னும் சொல்ல போனா டைகர் ப்ராஜெக்ட் சொல்லி கூட ஒரு ப்ராஜெக்ட் இருக்கு. இன்னும் ரெண்டு மூணு ப்ராஜெக்ட்ஸ் இருக்கு. அவங்க என்னன்னா பர்டிகுலரா இந்தியன் கேட்டகரி, இந்தியா சப்கான்டினென்ட்ல இருக்கக்கூடிய விலங்குகளை பத்தி மட்டும் எழுதக்கூடிய ஒரு டீம் இருக்காங்க. ஸோ அவங்க வந்து விலங்குகளோ பறவைகளோ பத்தி ஆர்டிகல்ஸ் இம்ப்ரூவ் பண்ணுவாங்க, அதை வந்து மெயின்டைன் பண்ணுவாங்க, ஏதாவது தப்பு நடந்தா கூட அதை ரிவர்ட் பண்ணுவாங்க. ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி நீங்க டென்டல்ன்ற டீம் எடுத்து கூட ஒரு ப்ராஜெக்ட் இனிஷியேட் பண்ணலாம். இது ஒன் டே ப்ராஜெக்ட் இருக்கலாம், லாங்
ஷார்ட்டா வந்து இப்போ நம்ம இன்ஸ்டிடியூஷன்ஸ்க்குள்ள இது பண்றோம் அப்படின்னா இந்த விக்கிமீடியாவுடைய அப்ளிகேஷன்ஸ் எப்படி இது பண்ணலாம் சார்?
ஓ, இன்ஸ்டிடியூஷனுக்குள்ளே சொல்கிறீங்களா?
ஆமாம்
சார். இன்ஸ்டிடியூஷனுக்குள்ளேன்னா பார்த்தீங்கன்னா இப்போ சொன்ன மாதிரி ஏதாவது
அதாவது இன்ட்ரா அந்த இன்டர் இன்டர் டிபார்ட்மெண்ட்லாம் இல்லை வந்து ஒரே ஸ்பெஷாலிட்டி அந்த மாதிரினா எப்படிங்க சார் இது?
நீங்களே வந்து ஒரு ப்ராஜெக்ட் கிரியேட் பண்ணிக்கலாம். விக்கிபீடியால ப்ராஜெக்ட் கிரியேட் பண்ணிட்டு உங்களோட ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸோட கான்ட்ரிபியூஷன்ஸ்லாம் வந்து ஒரு இடத்துல லிஸ்ட் அவுட் பண்ற மாதிரி பண்ணிட்டு நீங்க அங்க வந்து பாராமெடிக்ஸ் இல்ல மெடிசின் சம்பந்தப்பட்ட ஆர்டிகல்ஸ் நீங்க இம்ப்ரூவ் பண்ணலாம். நாட் ஒன்லி ஆர்டிகல்ஸ், நீங்க மல்டிமீடியா ஃபைல்ஸ் கான்ட்ரிபியூட் பண்ணலாம். நீங்க ஒரு டாக்குமெண்ட் பண்ணிருந்திருக்கலாம்.
ஆமாங்க சார், அது பார்த்தோம். அந்த கேसेस இந்த இதெல்லாம் கூட போஸ்ட் பண்ணலாம்.
கரெக்ட். வெறும் ஆர்டிகல் மட்டும் நாலேஜ் கிடையாது. சோ வேரியஸ் வேலயே நீங்க வந்து கான்ட்ரிபியூட் பண்ணலாம். சோ அத கான்ட்ரிபியூட் பண்ண ஏற்கனவே நிறைய கண்டென்ட்ஸ் இருக்கும், அதையும் நீங்க எடுத்து ரீயூஸ் பண்ணிக்கலாம். சோ ஏற்கனவே இந்த மாதிரி கான்ட்ரிபியூஷன் பண்ணக்கூடிய சில யுனிவர்சிட்டிஸ் இருப்பாங்க, அவங்களோட சேர்ந்து கூட ஏதாவது நீங்க கொலாபரேட்டிவாவும் நீங்க பண்ணலாம்.
ஓகே சார். பட் தட் அந்த கேஸ் போட்டோஸ் அந்த மாதிரி இது போடும்போது அதனுடைய காப்பிரைட்ஸ் வந்து அந்த பர்டிகுலர் ஆத்தருக்கு வந்து இதாயிடும் இல்லைங்களா சார்?
ஆமா, அப்ப நீங்க பாத்தீங்கன்னா அந்த அதாவது கிரியேட்டிவ் காமன்ஸ் அப்படிங்கிற லைசன்ஸ்ல இருக்கக்கூடிய கண்டென்ட் மட்டும் தான் நீங்க யூஸ் பண்ண முடியும். அதுல நீங்க கிளியரா இருக்கணும். நீங்க இன்கேஸ் காப்பிரைட்டடான இருக்கக்கூடிய ஒரு கண்டென்ட் இருக்குன்னா அதை நீங்க போட முடியாது. அப்படியும் அதுக்கான ஒரு பிளாட்ஃபார்ம் விக்கிபீடியா கிடையாது. இது வந்து நாலேஜ் ஷேரபிளா இருக்கணும் அப்படின்றது தான் அதோட மெயினான ஒரு பில்லர். அப்ப நீங்க வந்து காப்பிரைட் இல்லாத கண்டென்ட், காப்பிரைட்ன்ற சொல்றது என்னன்னா அந்த ஓனருக்கு கிரெடிட்ஸ் கொடுப்போம், அட்ரிபியூட்ஸ் இருக்கும், பட் அவங்க வந்து எந்த ரெஸ்ட்ரிக்ஷன் கொடுக்க கூடாது. இப்ப நீங்க ஒரு 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 இமேஜ் போட்டு இந்த இமேஜ் மட்டும் தான் சொந்தம், யாரும் ரீயூஸ் பண்ணக்கூடாது அப்படின்னு நீங்க சொல்லக்கூடாது.
ஓகே சார்.
அப்படியே நீங்க அதாவது லைசன்ஸ் நீங்க டிக்ளேர் பண்ணும்போது நீங்க ஒரு இது அப்லோட் பண்றப்ப அந்த லைசன்ஸ் நீங்க சூஸ் பண்ணுவீங்க. அந்த லைசன்ஸ் நீங்க சூஸ் பண்ணிட்டு நீங்க அப்லோட் பண்ணீங்கன்னா அந்த லைசன்ஸ் அந்த ஒரு இமேஜுக்கு அப்ளை ஆயிரும். ஒரு டெக்னிக்கலா அங்க எங்கேயும் நீங்க வந்து ஹோல்டு பண்ண முடியாது. இன்னும் சொல்ல போனா படங்களே கூட காப்பிரைட்டடா வந்துட்டு தான் இருக்கு, நம்ம அப்படி யாரும் ரெஸ்ட்ரிக்ட் பண்ண முடியாது. இது வந்து ஒரு லீகலா நம்ம ஒரு நோட்டீஸ் கொடுக்குறோம்.
So is there any other questions from us, from our side?
Questions ready, nama session wind up pannikalam. சார் அவரோட இமெயிலும் இருக்குது, என்னோட இமெயிலும் கொடுத்துருக்கேன் nichilkaran@gmail.com. ஏதாவது இந்த மாதிரி க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் இருந்தால் கூட நீங்கள் டைரெக்டாக கூட மெயிலில் காண்டாக்ட் பண்ணலாம்.
ஃபார்மசி பிரின்சிபல் சார் இருக்காங்களா?
Good evening to all. On behalf of JKK Nataraja Educational Institution, so first of all, I thank our management for organizing this wonderful workshop on various aspects of Wikimedia application last 3 days afternoon session. For all the students and faculty members of JKK Nataraja Educational Institution, so first of all, I thank our director for arranging this wonderful workshop for our students. I thank you, sir. Next, I thank my hearty thanks to our special guest, Nichal Karan, of this workshop. Thank you very much, sir. On behalf of all the students and faculty members of JK Nataraja College of Pharmacy, so you are spending your valuable 3 days with us. We are really happy, and this session is very wonderful. So I hope all the students and faculty members are take this session workshop in future to a great height. Once again, on behalf of all the students and faculty, I thank your valuable presentation last 3 days. So again, I thank the resource person of this session workshop, Bhavana, Sabad, Jayant and Aslin. They are presenting details about this application of Wikimedia. Finally, I thank Nazar Khan, the program coordinator, because I know each and every program, how organizing, what is the difficulties of organizing a one-day program, but 3 days with a lot of students, faculty members, HOD, principal, is arranging this program is a wonderful manner. I thank Nazar Khan his effort for arranging all the 3 days workshop. Thank you, sir. And also I thank all the principals, HODs, faculty members and students. You try to utilize this opportunity. They will try to implement in a regular basis. And we have to create this Wikimedia. We'll try to work Wikimedia daily basis. We'll try to show our talent in this session. Finally, I thank management and the Nichal Karan for your wonderful workshop. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Mr. Nichal Karan, shall we close the session? Hello.
Sir, I think he left the meeting, sir.
That's right. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Onandal. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.